Hello, I'm Karano from Physiology Department, School of Medical Sciences, University Science, Malaysia. In this video, we are going to talk about perfusion. First, let us start with pulmonary blood flow, which explains the blood to the lungs, from the lungs, and in the lungs. The lungs receive two blood supplies. The most important one is from the pulmonary arteries. Blood from the pulmonary arteries is originated from the right ventricle. They carry deoxygenated blood to the lungs for oxygenation. Pulmonary arteries divided into smaller arteries and arterioles, which forming smaller branches and form pulmonary capillaries or alveolar capillary networks. At these capillaries, the blood will be oxygenated because there is a higher pressure of oxygen in the alveoli in compared to the capillary. The oxygenated capillary blood then drain into venules, small veins, and into the pulmonary vein, and the blood will be delivered to the left atrium of the heart to be delivered to the rest of the body via systemic circulation. This blood circulation between the heart and the lungs refers to as pulmonary circulation. Another blood supply of the lungs is from the bronchial arteries, which come from the thoracic aorta. It carries oxygenated blood to the supporting tissues of the lungs. The bronchial veins carry deoxygenated blood from the lungs tissues to the pulmonary veins and to the left atrium of the heart. So this blood bypasses the alveoli. This is called physiological shunt. A shunt refers to a portion of the cardiac output or blood flow that is diverted or rerouted. Another example of physiologic shunt is the coronary blood flow that drains directly into the left ventricle through the tibetan veins and never perfuses the lungs. These right-to-left physiologic shunts accounts for about 2% of cardiac output and always present. So arterial pressure of oxygen will always be slightly less than the alveolar pressure. There are also pathological shunts, either right-to-left shunts or left-to-right shunt. Right-to-left shunt can occur if there is a defect in the wall between the right and left ventricles. In this shunt, hypoxemia always occurs because a significant amount of the cardiac output is not delivered to the lungs for oxygenation. Left to right shunts are more common, such as in patent ductus arteriosus and traumatic injury. These shunts do not cause hypoxemia because the oxygenated blood that has just returned from the lungs is added directly to the right heart without being delivered to the systemic tissues. So, to sum up, the lungs receive two blood supplies from the pulmonary arteries and bronchial arteries. Alveolar perfusion or pulmonary perfusion refers to the pulmonary blood supplying the alveoli and is involved in gas exchange. Alveolar perfusion is determined by the pressure in pulmonary arteries, pulmonary veins, and air in the alveoli. The difference in these pressures will allow gas exchange process to occur. Blood flow distribution to the lungs is uneven. It is affected by gravitational effect on hydrostatic pressure, which is the weight of blood in the vessel. If a person is supine, blood flow is nearly uniform, because the entire lung is at the same gravitational level. However, when a person is upright, there is gravitational effect on the blood flow distribution. So the blood flow to the entire lungs is not uniform. It is lowest at the apex and highest at the base of the lungs. In zone 1, because of gravity, arterial pressure may be lower than alveolar pressure. So, the pulmonary capillaries will be compressed by the higher alveolar pressure. This compression will cause the capillaries to close, so blood flow is reduced. In zone 1, blood flow is the lowest compared to other zones. In zone 2, because of the gravitational effect on hydrostatic pressure, arterial pressure is higher than in zone 1 and higher than alveolar pressure. But the alveolar pressure in zone 2 is higher than venous pressure. So, although there is no compression of the capillaries in zone 2, blood flow is driven by the difference between arterial and alveolar pressure, not by the difference between arterial and venous pressure, which is actually the common driven factor in systemic vascular beds. In zone 3, the pattern is more familiar. The gravitational effect increases both arterial and venous pressures, and they are both higher than alveolar pressure. So similar to other vascular beds, blood flow to zone 3 is driven by the difference between arterial and venous pressure. So in zone 3, more capillaries are open and blood flow is the highest. So throughout the lungs, perfusion is highest at the base and lowest at the apex. So throughout this video, we have learned about pulmonary perfusion. The lungs receive two blood supplies. The major one is from the pulmonary arteries that carries deoxygenated blood, which will be oxygenated at the alveolar. The minor blood supply is from the bronchial arteries, which carries oxygenated blood for the metabolic function of the bronchi and lungs tissues. This minor blood supply is called physiologic shunt. Then we look at alveolar perfusion, which is the blood flow to the alveoli. It is very much dependent on the arterial pressure, venous pressure, and alveolar pressure. For this reason, the pulmonary blood flow throughout the lungs is uneven. It is very much dependent on the gravitational effects on hydrostatic pressure of the blood in the vessel. Pulmonary perfusion is highest at the base of the lungs and lowest at the apex of the lungs. So, that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.